What am I talking
about? And we are back on air, Olga Show for you. Hello, everyone. This is Saturday night, and we are back live on air. So this is Olga with you. You can call us at 408-912-5265, 408-912-5265. You can also watch us on Ustream, and you will have notification if you will be our subscriber. So as soon as we get on air, you will know about it. Also on YouTube, we will have our show today ready for you in about 48 hours. Thank you to Google and YouTube making it available. We have guests as usual in our show tonight because we're going to talk about all fancy organic food and how we can indulge ourselves with a wonderful food today, because I have been visiting, and so is my guest, Winter Fancy Food Show. As you can see, saliva in my mouth keep coming of all of the food, fancy food I try, all this French food. And we need more mics because we have more guests probably here, so everybody has a mic ready. Great. Okay. And Winter Fancy Food Show, that was 39th show in San Francisco. They had 210,000 square feet, over 3,000 exhibitors. And it's known as a spectacular educational opportunity for startups, mature manufacturers, retailers, and others in the food industry. So what else is available? Of course, we had inspirational words, and the Specialty Food Association presented leadership awards honoring individuals from our membership who have advanced food standards in society and society itself by creating social, economic, and environmental impact through innovation and vision. And that's happened during Winter Fancy Food Show. We're actually trying to invite those visionaries to our show, and we will keep you posted. And one of the Saturday nights you will be able to see. But meanwhile, let's come back to our local exhibitors who have been at the show and brought all kinds of stuff here. I see lots of bags. How about you introduce yourself? Hello, everyone.
Hello, and thanks for having us on the show, Olga.
Okay.
My name's Bridget McQueen, and this is my husband Tomek. And
hello.
Hello.
Some may know of us in the Bay Area. We're our local pierogi provider. Pierogi is a type of Polish dumpling that you just boil, and you can fry it later. Some call it the Polish pot sticker.
Or ravioli. Or,
it's very similar to ravioli, but it looks a little bit like a pot sticker. And we exhibited for the first time at the Fancy Food Show this year. So this was kind of like our big coming out to the market and letting everybody know we exist. So it was a phenomenal show for us. And we can talk about the flavors that we showed at the show if you'd like.
Sure. I have like five bags here. Potato and cheese pierogi, by the way. Pierogi, that's how we say it in Russian language. And it's probably similar what you do, but we will find out more because you definitely have kind of more advanced fillings in those piroshkis, we call it, right?
Mm-hmm.
But you call them pierogi.
I think they are more maybe closer to Russian varenki.
Okay, yes, varenki, like yes.
This actually is
Ukrainian.
Yeah, yes. Or Ukrainian, yes.
Ukrainian, like that. Because I think that depends what part of Ukraine or Lithuanian you are, like they're from, or like the Russia. I think Russia practically called this varenki, but when you go to Lithuanian, closer to Polish border, they call this pierogi.
Okay.
Closer to Russia, probably is varenki, because we met so many people from Ukraine and like the Lithuanian, and they always call different way.
All right, so you go under Polska Foods.
Exactly.
Yes, that is
Polska Food, and we can find you in Whole Foods stores.
And Lenardi's, Molly Stone's, a lot of small independents. If you go to our website, it's polskafoods.com. You can actually go to a store locator. It says find a store. You put your zip code in, and because there could be some small independent store that's right around the corner from you. You know, it's great to support the local vendors as well, especially those independent stores.
And I have my wonderful intern, Ashwin, had an opportunity to try that. So what can you tell us about it? This was your first time to try it.
The first time he's ever had pierogi, yeah. Actually, ever.
The first time I've ever had pierogi, and I had the spinach, and I had this, wait, what's something? Yeah, I said the potato and cheese, the savory beef and pork, and I also had the mushroom cabbage. I've actually never had, like, sauerkraut before, so that was also a first. My favorite of the three was the savory beef and pork burger. That has, like, really nice kick to it afterwards and just tastes super good. I also like the, I liked all of them. They were all really good. The potato one is, it tasted cheesy in potato. I'm not a food critic. I like food, but I don't make super deep comments.
Well, let me tell you about the potato cheese. This can help. A lot of people, when they've had pierogi, they'll just have potatoes and onions or maybe a little bit of cheese. What we've done is actually done, the main ingredient is farmer's cheese. And we get the farmer's cheese out of Berkeley. It's a handcrafted, award-winning custom cheesemaker that is makes our batch of farmer's cheese custom-made for...
What's the name of the farmer?
It's Belfiore Cheese. And
okay. They maybe agreed to be at our show. I'm not sure if so many people agree to it. So I had to break them down and every week, so it means that every Saturday we're going to try different food. So we nice. Will become so picky in the food.
Exactly. So we're the first fun. Ones, yeah.
First one, we're like guinea pigs of my fancy food show, because I said, well, I don't know how to explain exhibitors that we cannot actually eat in the studio, but we will be happy to eat during, not during the show, but before the show and after the show.
Yes.
So, and then we can always give our opinion and express our gratitude to our sponsors to talk
yeah,
about.
Yeah, the potato cheese is different. The farmer's cheese is the main ingredient. The second one is actually whole grain organic millet. Which is, you say the label, it's potato cheese, right? And actually, potato is the third ingredient and the least ingredient, which makes it really different. Have you ever cooked with millet, or have you had millet before?
Oh, yeah, because, see, I'm
from Russia. Yeah, you guys like
millet,
a lot of millet, right?
Okay. You put lots of milk into it and even butter and make it really nice, especially for breakfast.
Exactly.
So you kind of put all together here. That's unusual.
Well, millet's such a healthy grain. It's high in magnesium, your B vitamins. It's really high in fiber, actually protein, and even low on the glycemic index for a whole grain. And they've been cooking with millet for thousands of years. Actually goes back 10,000 years before rice even. And it just has this really creamy texture and flavor. And so it really adds not just the health aspect, but I think it adds really the flavor too and texture. And then we actually add a roasted garlic, a lot of fresh herbs. So you're getting a real herbed potato cheese pierogi, but once you try it too, we use a very thin dough, very delicate, just supposed to kind of melt in your mouth.
So it's like almost like pelmeni or dumplings in Chinese. So pelmeni is in Russian. Mm-hmm. So it's not like really pierogi here. And you write vareniki because it has different fillings inside. No added sugar, no preservatives, no trans fat, no RBST free product, no GMO. So no MSG, lactose free, no hormones. I mean, my God, I'm reading all your labels. So you are really more into organic, healthy food style. Why is that?
Well, we eat, actually I have a background in food and nutrition, and we just happen to be very picky eaters ourselves. And there's a lot of debate of people who choose to go organic or not. Mm-hmm. Some do it for environmental reasons. Some just don't want a lot of pesticides and insecticides in their body, which makes a lot of sense. And then there's the other, side of it which is a little bit more controversial, in that organic food actually has more nutrition. And from the research we've seen, I actually do agree that organic food has more nutrition. There was one study that came out in 2010. And it was done by the Journal of Agriculture and Food Chemistry. And it said, oh, look it, antioxidants are the same in organic food. And everybody, went crazy with the news on that. But actually, if you look at the study in detail, they only studied one aspect of antioxidant, which was the polyphenols.
Right.
But if you look at all antioxidants, and especially ones that you would typically find in an organic soil that is not going to be in your regular high processed manufactured food, it's going to be things like selenium, zinc, iron, magnesium that is going to be more an organic type of food. And that is every study that they've shown. When you really look at all the antioxidants, organic is always way higher in nutritional value than conventional farming. So that's sort of for us. You know, we really believe in eating organic, and so everything that we do in our products, we try to get as much organic as we possibly can. There are some ingredients that we just can't get organic, so we do everything else that we can. So
you have potato and cheese pierogi, then you have spinach and feta pierogi with roasted bell peppers, portobello mushrooms. Here you can see it on the Ustream and YouTube. Then mushroom and cabbage pierogi with fresh sauerkraut and caramelized onions.
And that one is actually our vegan pierogi, and there's a really fun story with that one. That is actually Tomek's grandma's recipe from Poland. We didn't modify a single thing in there. We take the fresh sauerkraut. It's not with preservatives. It's really naturally fermented cabbage with just cabbage and salt. And then you're adding caramelized onions and cremini mushrooms, and you slowly saute that for hours to just bring out this sort of a sweet and sour flavor mixed together, and then you just put in an organic, very delicate organic dough. So we get this featured in a lot of vegetarian and vegan, actually the Vegetarian Journal magazine just featured the product, and it's kind of becoming known in the vegan market, which is really great because it wasn't made to be vegan, but it is. It was just a very old, ancient recipe that just tasted really good.
Now it has fancy word, vegan.
Yeah.
Sometimes scares people because it's too healthy, it doesn't taste good. But
I don't know.
I've tried it tastes really good.
See, yeah, and I believe my intern, he's not first day here, so and he wasn't at the fancy food show. I just getting him prepared. Maybe next year he will go and see on his own. I slowly prepare him for the conferences I go to because it gets like outrageously good. And you get spoil yourself when you get to know where the industry goes, or it's in technology, or in the food industry, or it could be Mac world coming up, or it could be something else, like database structure, or big data, because now all of you creating big data as well, which I have to analyze as a producer of the show. We will be back in about couple of minutes because we have commercial break coming up. Thank you to our sponsors. For those who just join in, you're listening to Olga Show. We're going to talk about all about organic food and especially Polska foods and their pierogi styles, preparation, easy cooking, frozen type of dumplings they're offering through healthy stores and available on the market already here in local California area, local stores like Whole Foods, Molly's, Drager's.
Not Drager's yet, but Lenardi's.
Lenardi's, yes.
And some Safeways.
And Safeway as well, yeah. Actually, in Vons in Southern California, up in Oregon, Washington, and also the East Coast now.
All right, so we will find out all about this small business which grows so tremendously.
Thank you for listening.
That's great. So we're still on the Ustream.